Hello friends, welcome to Sushmita's classroom. I hope all of you are in best of your health and mood. Here we take some virtual trips time to time to remove our boredom, and before taking the trip, we normally discuss about the reasons why people love to travel. In the continuity of that, today we will again discuss another reason, and that is escaping. A demanding job, a bad breakup, the loss of loved one. At this time, if people eat, pray or travel, they will get great relief from the stress and unhappiness that come along with them. People seek from their travels what they don't have back home. Better weather, nicer scenery, the freedom to do what they want, experiences they can't normally have, a slower, relaxing pace, admiring masterpieces in the Louvre, or lying on a beach are wonderful breaks from the regular grind. Travel is particularly helpful for workaholics who have trouble leaving their job behind. Stepping away from the workplace is good for you, both mentally and physically. When you return to the job, you will have had the space to look at issues with fresh eyes. Travel has the power to let you not only escape but also heal. A new place with lots of fun distractions can work wonders. You will return home more at peace with yourself and your challenging situations. So, let's begin our trip to Thiruvananthapuram and Kanyakumari today. Thiruvananthapuram, the jewel in the emerald necklace that Kerala is for the Indian subcontinent, must surely have Parashuraman been a must-see destination of ages, long before National Geographic travelers classified it as one. Surely, long before sage Parashurama, according to local legend, threw his divine battle axe from Kanyakumari to Gokaram to West Kerala, God's own land, from the Varuna, the sea god, before the times of Mahabali, the democratic and just ruler of this wonderful land, who was sent down to the netherworld through the sea. It does not take any flights of fancy to imagine that this land fired the imaginations of intrepid travelers and explorers like Columbus, Vasco da Gama, Marco Polo, Fa Hien, and quite possibly countless others from the pages of history, recorded or not. It is formerly known as Trivandrum, situated at India's southwestern end, in the capital of the state of Kerala. The word Thiruvananthapuram means the city of Lord Anantha, the serpent Shesha, or whom Lord Padmanabha or Vishnu reclines, in both Malayalam and Sanskrit languages. Spreading over an area of 250 square kilometers, Thiruvananthapuram is located at an average elevation of about 16 feet above the sea level, with numerous historic monuments, a far-reaching shoreline giving it some of the most beautiful beaches, backwater stretches, and a rich cultural heritage. It is a popular tourist destination in Kerala and in India. Top sites of Thiruvananthapuram are Sri Padmanabha Swami Temple. It is a Hindu temple located in the state capital of Kerala. The temple is built in an intricate fusion of the Chera style and the Dravidian style of architecture, featuring high walls and a 16th century Gopura. The principal deity Padmanabha Swami is enshrined in the Anantha Shayana posture, the eternal yogic sleep on the serpent Adishesha. Naipur Museum. This is about 6 km from the city. It was established in 1855. It was designed by Robert Chisholm, the consulting architect of the Madras government. Naipur Museum is a landmark in the city with its unique ornamentation and architectural style with Gothic roof and minarets. The Indo-Saracenic structure also boasts a natural air conditioning system. The museum houses a rare collection of archaeological and historic artifacts, bronze idols, ancient ornaments, a temple chariot, and ivory carvings. Shanghu Mugam Beach. It is at a distance of about 10 km from Thiruvananthapuram Central Railway Station. It is a famous beach. Sunset at this beach is worth watching. Veli Tourist Village. This picnic spot where the Veli Lake meets the Arabian Sea offers boating facilities. The Veli Beach is 8 km away from Thiruvananthapuram town. The charming city has plenty of heritage sites to offer visitors, but after exploring it, one could travel to the famous southernmost tip of India, Kanyakumari. During the British era, Kanyakumari was called Cape Comorin. Apart from being the southernmost point of the Indian peninsula, this town is also where one can see the union of three bodies of water, the Indian Ocean, the Bay of Bengal, and the Arabian Sea. The ferry ride from the mainland to the Vivekananda Rock Memorial and onwards to the Thiruvalluvar statue is another experience to look forward to. Vivekananda Rock Memorial is on the Lakshadweep Sea. It is here where Swami Vivekananda meditated for 3 days and decided to dedicate the rest of his life to humanity. Thiruvalluvar statue is another short ferry ride away. It is one of the tallest statue in India. This was erected in the year 2000 to honor the Tamil philosopher and poet Velluvar. It is advisable to start early in the morning from Thiruvananthapuram to have sufficient time for all the sightseeing spots on the way to Kanyakumari. It will take approximately 3 hours to reach to Kanyakumari. The distance is almost 100 km, best covered via National Highway 66. The other important places to see are Kanyakumari, Bhagwati Amman Temple, Government Museum, Padmanabhapuram Palace, Kanyakumari Sunset Viewpoint, etc. Post sunset, one can driven back to Thiruvananthapuram with a halt somewhere for dinner. Shopping in Thiruvananthapuram. There are many places to enjoy local and street shopping in Thiruvananthapuram, like MG Road, Konimara Market, Kerali Handicrafts, Chalai Market, SS Street, Balrampur Kaithari, etc. Thiruvananthapuram is famous for handloom fabrics, wood, brass, ovings, and spices. The traditional kasabu sari, which is actually a white sari with a golden border, is must to buy from here. Thiruvananthapuram International Airport connects a number of cities in India and abroad. Quite a good number of trains are available each hour that connect the city to the entire nation. If someone plans a trip by road, then there is also not a big worry, because there are continuous bus services to important parts of the country. I hope you like this journey, so stay connected for the next trip. Till then, take care. Bye.